वेलकम एवरीवन, माय नेम इज सौम्या तिवारी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर स्कूल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट स्टडीज, उत्तर प्रदेश, राष्ट्रीय टंडन. इन द सीरीज ऑफ बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट बीकॉम 203 एज वेल एज बीबीए 103N, वी विल डिस्कस टॉपिक फिजिकल एंड मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी. लेट्स मूव ऑन. फर्स्ट, व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय द टर्म मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी? मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी एज डिफाइंड बाय जॉनसन इज अ पॉलिसी दैट एम्प्लॉयज सेंट्रल बैंक control of the supply of money as an instrument for achieving the objective of general economic policy. In layman terms, you can say that monetary policy is governed by central bank, that means RBI, that controls what? Four aspect. First is supply of money, Next is availability of money, that means loan. As well as cost of money, that means interest rate. Rate of interest. And this is done to achieve the objective that focuses on stability and growth of the economy. So, in short, central bank nothing but RBI that controls the supply of money, availability of money, as well as cost of money, that means the rate of interest they charge. So they achieve the objective that focuses on stability as well as growth of the economy. Next, what are the objective of monetary policy? First is full employment to create job opportunity for all. Next is price stability, that in order to control inflation as well as deflation. Next is economic growth. Next is balance of payment equilibrium, that means the amount that is Indian in currency is earning as well as that is paid to the other side of the country. So all that should be in equilibrium, that means the exchange rate should be in equilibrium. Next is reducing income inequality. These are the objective of monetary policy that can be done through various instruments provided by the RBI and central bank. Next, instruments of monetary policy. There are two types of instrument that is governed by the RBI. First is qualitative and the next is quantitative. Qualitative is also known as selective, and these can be divided into, first is moral suasion. What do you understand by the term moral suasion? That means RBI government tries to persuade commercial banks to follow the directives and of the policies. That means all the rules and regulation provided by the RBI should be followed by the commercial bank. But if commercial bank do not follow these directives, what they do? Direct action. They can take direct action on these commercial banks who do not follow the directives provided by the RBI. Next is marginal requirement. What do you mean by terms of margin requirement? That means if you are trying to provide some security against some loans, then you have to sustain some margin. For example, if you are trying to provide a security worth rupees 100, for against that the bank, commercial bank, is provided you 80 rupees. So there is a margin of 20 rupees. These 20 rupees is known as margin requirement. That is controlled by RBI. The RBI sets the limit how much margin has to be set up. And next is rationing of credit. This is nothing but that means that you need to have a control over the amount of credit or loans you are providing to to the public by the commercial bank through various activities. So there is a limit of credit provided to the public or industries, and that is set up by the RBI. Next is quantitative instrument that has been used for monetary policy. First is bank rate, cash reserve ratio, statutory reserve ratio, repo rate and reserve repo rate, as well as open market operation. First, we will discuss what you understand by the bank rate. Bank rate is also known as rediscount rate. This is a rate which RBI lends to the commercial bank. So, and or discounts the bill. If the bank rate is increased, that means the commercial bank has to pay more. For that purpose, it will impact that the commercial bank will also charge high rate of interest from the public. In turn, the public have less purchasing power. This in turn will control inflation. So when there is inflation, what does the RBI does? It increases the bank rate. So it is said it is the rate at which RBI lends to the commercial bank or rediscount their bills. If the bank rate is increased, then commercial bank also charges higher rate of interest on loan given by the banks to the public, because now commercial bank gets fund from RBI at high rate of interest. So RBI charges high rate of interest, then commercial bank will charge high rate of interest from the public, which in turn curtail the purchasing power of the public. So public have less money, so they will have the price level of the products and services will reduce. So in order to control inflation, bank rate need to be increased. Higher rate of interest will contract credit in the economy. That means purchasing power of the public is reduced. So public will take lesser loans because of higher rate of interest. Next, cash reserve ratio. What is cash reserve ratio? Cash reserve ratio is a certain percentage of the commercial bank deposit that has to be kept with the RBI. So these is a certain percentage of bank deposit which banks are required to keep with the RBI in the form of reserves or balance. The higher the CRR ratio, that means the more the amount they have, the commercial bank have to give to RBI. So the more the amount they give, the lesser they have to provide the public in form of loans. So the purchasing power of the public is again reduced. So in order to control inflation, the CRR is also increased. The higher the CRR with the RBI, lower will be the liquidity in the system and vice versa. So in order to control inflation, the CRR ratio is also increased. RBI is empowered to vary CRR between 15 to 3%. Next is statutory liquidity ratio. The commercial bank has to keep a certain portion of money with them in the form of liquidity, because in case of emergency, they need to keep a certain limit of their amount. So it means a certain percentage of deposit is to be kept by the firms in the form of liquid asset, those that can be transformed into money easily. So these is kept by the bank itself. Liquid assets here include government securities, treasury bills and other securities notified by the RBI. Those can be changed into money within a year. So if SLR is more, if they keep the commercial bank given the directive to keep the SLR percentage high, that means they have to assign a certain amount of their deposit in SLR. So the commercial bank will have less amount of deposit to provide them as a loan to the public. So in turn, they will provide less loan to public. So the purchasing power of the public is also curtailed. So if the SLR is more, then banks have to keep more part of deposit in a specified securities, and banks will have less surplus fund for granting loan. It will contract credit. So in turn, to reduce the inflation, they will try to contract the credit, and that can be done only if the SLR rate is more. Next is repo rate and reserve repo rate. When the RBI lends money to the commercial bank. It is known as repo rate. Repo rate is the rate at which RBI lends to commercial bank against the government securities. But when the RBI want to have some funds from the commercial bank, that means it wants to borrow money from the commercial bank, then a reserve repo rate is introduced. Reserve repo rate is the rate at which RBI borrows money from the commercial bank. So reduction in repo rate means help the commercial bank to get more money at cheaper rate. If you reduce the repo rate, commercial bank will have more money. They will supply the money in the economy to the public. So the purchasing power of the public is increasing. If you reduce the repo rate, if you increase the repo rate, then the purchasing power of the public is decreased. So in order to have some contract credit, that means in order to have control over the inflation, they will try to reduce repo rate. They will charge high repo rates. As the rates are high, the availability of credit and demand decreases, resulting to decreasing inflation. So, as I told you, when you have to control the inflation, you have to charge high rates. So, the increase in repo rate and reserve repo rate is a symbol of tightening of the policy. Next is, these are the update rates you need to check when you are trying to give the exam. All the rate changes within months, so you need to have some updated version. Right now, at this point, repo rate is 5.90%, 90%, and reserve repo rate is 3.35%, and cash reserve ratio, CRR rate is 4.50%, bank rate is 6.15%, and statutory liquidity ratio is 18%. This is the current ratio of all. Next is open market operation. This means the government, the bank tries to sell the open securities in the market to curtail the inflation. For example, the bank controls the flow of credit through the sale and purchase of securities in the open market. When it sells, what will happen? When it tries to sell the securities, the public and commercial bank will try to purchase it. When they purchase, the amount they have with them will be provided to the bank. So the amount of purchasing power of the public is reduced, thus they will contract the credit in the market. When there is deflation, that means the price level is low, they try to increase the price level, that means they try to increase the purchasing level of the public, then they purchase the securities from the open market. When they purchase, they try to provide money in the market, boost the economy. So when they provide money in the market, so the amount of purchasing power with the public increases, and thus in turn they will have a control over deflation. When securities are purchased by the central bank, then RBI makes the payment to commercial bank. So when they try to purchase, so they make RBI make payment to commercial bank. Now the commercial bank deposits have increased, they have increased, so they can provide more loans to the public. Now, loans are provided to the public, they have more purchasing power. So, and now they have more money with them. It increases money supply with the commercial bank and public. This will expand credit in the economy. So, when you need to expand the credit in the economy, you need to have sell the securities in the open market. Next is fiscal policy. Now, the monetary policy is governed by the RBI. The fiscal policy is governed by the government, and it takes the form of taxes, revenues, and public expenditures. So it refers to a policy concerning the use of state treasury or the government finance to achieve the macroeconomic goals. Government policy of changing its taxation and public expenditure programs intended to achieve the objectives. It is as same as monetary policy. Here the government is involved. Government have control over the first is taxation, next is public expenditure, and next is public revenue. So these three are with the objective that focus on growth and stability of the economy. So this is in turn fiscal policy. Fiscal policy is a government initiated measures to alter the tax rate and government spending for creating a macro level impact on the nation's economy. Here, when government tries to have control inflation, that means it will try to have contract the credit, as you have seen in monetary policy also. When the government is facing inflation, then it tries to contract the credit, and it can be done only when the government decreases government spending and increases tax. So how it can control the inflation? When it try to contract the credit, and it can be done only when the government spending is reduced and taxes are increased. That means when you try to increase the revenue from the public, you will increase the tax and you will reduce your government spending. So you will have more amount of money with will be with government. So the purchasing power of the public will decrease, and therefore the price level will reduce. So when there is inflation, you try to contract the credit, and it can be done only through reducing the government spending and increasing the taxes. On the other hand, when there is deflation in the economy, what you try to do? You try to boost the economy through government spending. That means government tries to spend more through spending in infrastructure or anything, and it tries to reduce the taxes. That will it will reduce taxes, so less people purchasing power is increased. Now the economy is boosted, so it will help to curtail the deflation. So here it is given by a representation: government spending is increased and taxes is reduced. So this is explanatory fiscal policy. That means you have tried to curtail the credit of with the government. Next is government spending is reduced and taxes is increased. That means you have tried to contract the credit. Here you tried to expand the credit. Here you tried to contract the credit. They both the instrument are used in government by the government. Next is objective of the fiscal policy. First is to achieve the equal distribution of wealth, to increase the in savings, to achieve economic stability as well as price stability. In another word, it tries to work at macro level. That means to tries to protect the and growth of the economy. So the instruments of fiscal policies are deficit policies, public expenditure, taxation policies, and public debt. You have heard of all these points in the previous examples. Let's move on to deficit policy. Deficit financing is nothing, that means financing to the budgetary deficit. When you have some budget deficit, you try to finance those through, so that is known as deficit financing. Budgetary deficit means excess of government expenditure over the government income. That means the government has expended its expenditure more than it has earned any revenue through taxes. So it means taking loans from the RBI of India by government to meet the budgetary deficit. So what when they have spent more than earning revenue, so what they tried? They tried to take the loan from the RBI, and then the RBI gives loan by issuing new currency. When they issue new currency, the value of the money will reduce, the value of money will fall. So fall in value will leads to increase in price level. Price level is increased, that means it will boost the inflation. So inflation is not good, but it is good at a stable level. It is not good when it is at increasing level. So deficit financing should be kept low. It must keep in mind that you are providing for the budgetary deficit, but it should be kept in moderate amount. Otherwise, it will be harmful for the economy, because inflation is not good if it is at the high rate. It leads to price rise in the economy. Thus, due to deficit financing, necessary funds are made available for the economic growth of the economy, and on the other hand, inflation of the country increases. So you need to keep a moderate check on the deficit policy. Next is public expenditure. That means you need to expend on government spending on the infrastructure through development and non-development activities. Public expenditure influences the economic activities of country very much. It can be of two kinds, that is development and non-development expenditure. Expenditure on developmental activities requires huge amount of capital. To construct a road, dam, anything, you need a huge amount of capital, and that cannot be done through earning the taxes only. So you need to have some public debt. You need to take some public debt for that purpose. So it cannot be available by the private sectors alone. It requires substantial increase in public expenditure. Public expenditure may be made in many ways: development of state enterprise, support to private sector, development of infrastructure and social welfare. Why these expenditures are done? For the development of state, for the development of private sector and development of infrastructure and social welfare altogether. Next is taxation policy. Taxation are the main source of revenue for the government, and it can be direct as well as indirect. Direct taxes are wealth taxes, income tax, and on the other hand, indirect taxes are custom duties, VAT, etc. So direct taxes are progressive in nature, whereas indirect taxes are not progressive. The objective of taxation policies are mobilization of resources to promote saving, as well as the most important, to bring equality of income and wealth. So that purpose the taxation policies are introduced. Next is monetary as well as fiscal policy differences. So the main focus is just to stabilize the economy, promote economic growth for the long and the short term. Whereas on the other hand, if you try to discuss the difference between them, the monetary policy is governed by the central bank, whereas on the other hand, fiscal policy is governed by the government. The monetary policies focus on the interest rate through change in bank rate, repo rate, reserve repo rate, CRR and SLR. Whereas on the other hand, fiscal policies focuses on government expenditures, spending and taxation. And it is faster when you tries to control the inflation and deflation. You tries to implement the monetary policy and it will provide you a faster result than the fiscal policy, which takes a longer period of time. It is on the demand side because it takes into account all the rate of interest, whereas on the supply side it takes into account the government expenditure, spending and taxation. It controls inflation. The major objective of the monetary policy can be said as it to control the inflation, whereas on the other hand, fiscal policy is at macro level, so it tries to provide the full employment and economic growth at the large level. Next, thank you. We will discuss in next series. Thank you.